Good morning, students, and welcome to today's class. So in the last class, we had started with the third chapter, that is multiples and factors, correct? So we saw what are prime numbers and composite numbers. What are prime numbers? Numbers that have only two factors, that is 1 and the number itself, are called prime numbers. And composite numbers are the numbers that have more than two factors. Okay, and 1 is called an unique number because it has only one factor, which is 1 itself. Okay, so we saw what is multiples and factors. So multiples are nothing but a multiple of a given number is obtained as a product of the given number and any counting numbers. Counting numbers are nothing but your regular numbers, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so on. Okay, then we have factors. So all numbers that can exactly divide a number without leaving a remainder are called as factors. Okay, so then we saw comparison of multiples and factors also. Correct, then we solved the problems which are there in your textbook. Then we did tests of divisibility. So what are the different tests of divisibility? For 2, whenever a number is ending with any of the even numbers, then the number is divided by or divisible by 2. Okay, then for 3, if the sum of the digits of the given number is divisible by 3, then the number is also divisible by 3. So we solve these questions, correct? Then 4. For a number to be divisible by 4, the last two digits, that is the digit in tens and ones place, should be divisible by 4. Okay? Then 4, to see if the number is divisible by 5, then the digit in the ones place should either be 5 or 0 for the number to be divisible by 5. Okay, then for 6, the number should be divisible by both 2 and 3. If the number is divisible by both 2 and 3, then the number is also divisible by 6. Okay, and for 8, just like 4, how tens and 1 should be divisible by 4, same way for divisibility by 8, the last 3 digits, that is hundreds, tens and ones, these 3 digits should be divisible by 8. Okay, then for 9, just like 3, the sum of the digits should be divisible by 9. Okay, and for 10, if the last digit, that is in ones place, if the digit is 0, then the number is divisible by 10. And for divisibility by 11, if the difference between the sum of digits in odd place and that in even place is 0 or a multiple of 11, then it is divisible by 11. So we'll see divisibility of 11 with a few questions later. Okay, so then we had to solve a few questions from this exercise. So let's do that now. So we had done A and B of question 1. Okay, so what we'll do now is we'll solve question number 2 and question number 3. Okay. Now here, check if the following are divisible by 4 and 8. So first number is 644. So for divisibility by 8, what you have to do, you have to check if the last two digits, that digit in ones and tens place, if it is divisible by 4. So we have 44 here. Now 44 is divisible by 4. If you divide 44 by 4, you get the remainder as 0. So it is divisible by 4. So that means 644 is divisible by 4. Okay, so 644, when you try to divide it by 8, it will not be divisible by 4. Okay, so 644 is not divisible by 4. Alright, so now next number, 2042. Here, for divisibility by 4, you can check the last two digits. Now here, 42 is not divisible by 4. So 2042 is also not divisible by 4. Okay, and the last three digits, that is 042. Again, it is 42 only. So 42 is not divisible by 8. So it is neither divisible by 2042. Okay, so this was question number 2. Question 2 A and B. C and D you'll have to try on your own. Okay, now question number 3. Check the following are divisible by 11. So here first we have 3410. So the divisibility rule for divisible by 11 is you have to find sum of digits in odd places. Though odd places here, first we'll write the number so you all can know which is odd place, which is even place. So we'll start from the left hand side. So this is 1, this is 2, this is 3, and this is 4. Okay, so sum of the digits in odd places. So odd places is 1 and 3 here. So 3 plus 1, which is 4. Okay, and the sum of digit in evens place, which is 4 and 0. 4 plus 0 is 4. Now once you find the sum, what you have to do, you have to find the difference between these two sums. So the difference is 4 minus 4, 0. Since the difference is 0, 3410 is divisible by 11. Okay, if the difference was not 0 but some other multiple of 11, for example, if it was 11, okay, or 22 or 33 or some multiple of 11, then the number will be divisible by 11. Okay, let's see another question. Now here, 23,415. Now, just so that you don't get confused, we'll again number the places. So this is 1, this is 2, 3, 4 and 5. Okay, so first we'll find the sum of digits in odd places, that is 2 plus 4 plus 5. So 2 plus 4 is 6 and 6 plus 5 is 11. So sum of digit in odd places is 11. Then sum of digits in even places, that is 3 plus 1, which is 4. Now the difference between 11 and 4, 11 minus 4 you have 7. So now the difference is not 0, but the difference, that is 7, is not a multiple of 11 also. So this number, that is 23,415, is not divisible by 11. Okay, it is not divisible by 11. So this was question number 3. 3A and 3B. Okay. So we did question 1, 2, 3. So we did the A and B problems of these three questions, correct? So question C and D, for all the three problems, you'll have to try and do it for homework. Okay, so these six problems you have to try for homework. Now, we'll do the next topic, that is prime factorization. So let's see what is prime factorization. So first of all, to know what is prime factorization, you'll need to know what is the meaning of prime numbers. So we know what are prime numbers. The numbers which have only two factors, which is 1 and itself, are called prime numbers. So meaning of prime factorization is, when a number is written as a product of its factors, the number is said to be factorized. For example, 16. Okay, a number 16, if I take, here I can write 16 as 8, 2s are 16, correct? So now here 8 and 2 are factors of 16. So I'm writing 16 as a product of 8 and 2, which are the factors. So that is, it means that the number is factorized. Okay, so there may be more than one way of factorizing a number. So they've taken 45 here. So you can factorize 45 as 1 into 45 or 3 into 15 or 5 into 9 or 3 into 3 into 5. Okay, so you can factorize the number either ways. Okay, so these are all factorized numbers. Now, but when we write a number as a product of its prime factors alone, then we call it prime factorization. When you write the product of factors, if the factors are all prime numbers, then that is called prime factorization. So here, there is only one set of prime factors for a given number. So there will be only one set of prime factors. So the prime factorization of 45 is 3 into 3 into 5. So here 3, 3, 5. 3 and 5 both are prime numbers. So this is prime factorization. Okay. So prime factorization helps us to find the HCF and LCM of given set of numbers. So we'll study HCF, LCM later. So first let's see prime factorization. Okay. So there are two methods which you can find the prime factors of numbers. First is the factor 3 method of prime factorization, and then is the division method. First we'll study the factor 3 method for prime factorization. So find the prime factorization of 56 is what they have told. Okay, so first you have to write 56 as the product of known factors. Now you know that 56 is 7 into 8. Okay, 7 8s is 56, correct? So we'll write 7 and 8 here. Now wherever they've given circles, write the prime numbers there. Now in 7 and 8, 7 is a prime number, so we'll write 7 in the circle, and in the rectangle we'll write 8, because 8 can be factorized further. Okay, so here 7 is prime, but 8 is composite numbers. So factorize it again. So how will you factorize 8? 2 4s is 8. So we'll write 2 here in the circle, and 4 again is a composite number, so we'll write it here. Okay, so you can further factorize 4 as 2 into 2. Correct. So we get 2 into 2. Now since all the factors are done and all the factors that are left now are prime numbers, you cannot factorize it any further. You cannot factorize it any further. So the factorized, or for the prime factors of 56 are 7 into 2 into 2 into 2. Okay, so you can just write the circled, okay, or the circled numbers as the prime factors. So we have 2 here into 2 into 2 into 7. Okay, so note that the prime numbers are enclosed in circles while the composite numbers are within a rectangle. So whenever you're drawing factor 3s, you have to remember that. Okay, so let's see an example now. Express 120 as the product of primes. Okay. Now here they have done two ways, method 1 and method 2. So first they have taken 120 as a product of 10 and 12, that is 10 12s are 120. Okay, so both 10 and 12 are composite numbers, so they are enclosed within rectangles. Okay, so now what we'll do, now 10, see here, so 10 again will factorize it as 2 5s are 10. Now 2 and 5 are both prime numbers, so they are enclosed within circles. Okay, so we cannot factorize these any further because they are prime numbers. Now coming back to 12 here. Now 12, you can factorize it as 3 4s are 12. So 3 is a prime number, so it will be within a circle. And 4 is a composite number, so it will be within a rectangle like this. Now 4, 2 2s are 4, so we'll write 2 2s are like this within circles because 2 is a prime number. So to write the prime product of primes for 120, what you will write? You will do 2 into 2. Okay, and there's one more 2 here. First you write all the smaller prime numbers. So 2 into 2 into 2, then into 3 into 5. Okay, so this is one way of factorizing 120. Another way is, now we took 10 into 12, correct? 10 12s are 120. We know they can be in various numbers of factors for a composite numbers. So 4 into 30 is another way of writing 120. So we'll write 4 into 30. Okay, but now 4 here we can factorize it further as 2 into 2. And since 2 is prime number, you can enclose it within circles. So this will be the end of this branch. Okay, now we have 30 here. So 30 here is 2 into 15. Okay, so now again 2 is a prime number, so it will be within a circle. 15 is not a prime number, so it will be within a rectangle. So 15 is 3 5s are 15. Now 3 and 5 are both prime numbers, so that will be all. You cannot factorize any further. So to write it as a product, it will be 2 into 2 into 2 into 3 into 5. So you take you factorize it anywhere in the beginning, 10 into 12 or 4 into 20. The final prime factorization will be the same. Okay, it will be the same. So this is factor 3 method. Now we have the division method. Okay, so prime factorize 48 by division method. So what are the steps here? So first step, write 48 like this. 48, and now first start dividing by small prime numbers. The smallest prime number is 2, and since 48 can be divided by 2, we'll just write 2. Now here you can see 4 is there. So we know 2 2s are 4, so we'll write 2 here. And then we have 8 in 1's place. We know 2 4s are is right 8, so we'll write 4. Okay, so 2 into 24 is 48. Then again we'll write 2 here. Okay, so now 2 1's are 2, so we'll write 1. And 2 4's are is, sorry, 2 2's are is 4, so we'll write 2. Okay, so we got 12. Now since 12 is still an even number, we can still divide it by 12. Okay, now we have 2 here, so 2, we have 12, and we know 2 6 is 12, so we'll write 6 here. Okay, now then 2 3s is 6. Now continue till you arrive at a prime number dividend. Okay, now 3 is there here, which is a prime number, so you cannot go any further, so this is all. So 48 is 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 3. Okay, so this is prime factorization by division method. Now let's solve the questions which are there in your book. Okay, so first we have find the prime factorization using factor 3 method. So first number is 72. Okay, so they have given you the first factor also, 8. So 8, how many times is 72? 8, 9's are 72. So in this box we'll have 9. Okay, so first let's complete this branch. So 9, what are the factors of 9? You can write 9 as 3 3's are 9, correct? It's 3 into 3. So 3 is a prime factor, so we'll stop it there. Or a prime number. So now we have 8. We know 2 4's are 8. Now here they have given a circle, it means it should be a prime number. So we'll write 2 here, which is a prime number. In this rectangle, it means it's a composite number. So 4 is a composite number, so we'll write 4. So 2 4's are 8. Now what are the two prime numbers which you multiply, you will get 4, that is 2 into 2, correct? So 2 2's are 4. Okay, so the prime factors for 72 are 2 into 2 into 2 into 3 into 3. Okay, so this was for 72. Now for 100, now 100 they have given as 25 into something, so that is 4 25s are is 100, so this will be 4. Now for the factorizing 4, you will have 2 2s are 4. Since they have given circle, it means it's a prime number. Okay, now 25. So both are circles again, so there will be prime numbers only. So that is 5 5s are 25, correct? So 5 and 5. So it will be 2 into 2 into 5 into 5 is equal to 100. Okay, these are the prime factors for 100. Then 45. So 9 how much is 45? 9 5 is 45. Now since it's a circle, it means it's a prime number. So 5 is the prime number, so we'll write 5. Then 9 we have. So 9 is 3 3 is a 9. So we'll write 3 and 3 here. Okay, so this is a C1. Now I want you to try D1 on your own. Okay, I want you to try D1 on your own. Now use the factor 3 method to prime factorize and use the division method to prime factorize. So we'll solve question 2 and 3 now. Okay, so I want you to do question number D of question 1 and question 4 here, that is factorize by division method, verify by factor 3 method. Basically you have to do both the methods, and if your answers are matching, it means your answer is verified. Okay, so do this for homework and question D also for homework. Now we'll do question 2 and 3. So question number 2, first one is 40, correct? So for 40, how will you write 40? You can write 40 as 10 4s are 40. So we'll factorize it as 10 and 4. Then, now this 10, you can factorize further it as 5 into 2. Now since 5 and 2 are both prime numbers, you'll stop factorization there only. Then we have 4. Now 4 is 2 into 2. So the factors for 40 here, what are the factors or the prime factors? Basically 40 is equal to 2 into 2 into 2 into 5, correct? So you'll multiply 2 3 times and 5. So these are the prime factors for 40. Okay, and then the next one, 50. 54. So how, what are the factors for 54? One way to write 54 is 6 into 9. Correct. So we'll write 6 into 9. Since 6 and 9 are both composite numbers, we'll factorize it again. So 6 you can factorize as 3 into 2, and 9 you can factorize it as 3 into 3. So 54 is equal to 2 into 2. Okay, there's only 1, 2. So 2 into 3 into 3 into 3. Okay, so these are the prime factors for 54. Then the last one is 110. So 110, now 110 you can either do it as 11 tensa, or you can do it as 2 into 55. So when you do 11 tensa, now here I'll have 11. 11 is a prime number, and here I'll have 10. So 10 will be 2 into 5. So you'll basically get the same factors, but the numbers will be, it will be a different method, that's all. So here first I've done 2 into 55. So 2 is a prime number, so we'll write it in a circle, and 55 here. So 11 5 is 55, correct? So we'll write 11 and 5 here. So the prime factors for 110 are 2 into 5 into 11. Alright, 2 into 5 into 11. I hope you understood how to do the factor tree prime factorization. It is called a tree because it has branches and all of it. It looks like branches of trees. Now, question 3. Use the division method to prime factorize. So the first question is 70. Okay, so what we'll do, when you do prime factorization by division method, you always use the smallest prime number first to divide. So the smallest prime number to divide is 2, correct? So you can start dividing by 2. Now 2 3s are 6, so you will write 3 here. Then we can write 1 here. Then 2 5s are 10, so you can write 5. So 2 35s are is 70. Okay, but then you can't carry on with 5 anymore, so you will cannot divide by 2 anymore, so you will move on to the next prime factor, which is 3. But 35 is not divided by 3 completely or divisible by 3, so we'll divide it by 5. Okay, so 5 7s are is 35. Now since 7 here is a prime number, you cannot divide further. Okay, so 70 is 7 into 5 into 2, or 2 into 5 into 7. Okay, so you can use the short division method which you'll have learned to do prime factorization. Then question number B is 50. So first we'll start with 2. 2 2s is 4, correct? 2 2s are 4, so we'll write 2 there, 2 below 5, and then here we have 1 will be remaining, so 2 5s are 10, so we'll write 5. Then 5 5s are 25, correct? So we cannot divide it by 2 anymore, and 3 also, so we'll divide it by 5. So 5 5s are 25. So 50 is 2 into 5 into 5, or 5 into 5 into 2. Okay, so this is question B. And the last question, that is 32. So 2 16s are 32, that is 2 1s are 2, 1 will remain. So 2 6s are 12. Then continue with 2 only, 2 8s are 16, we know that, so we'll write 8. Since it is still divisible by 8, we'll do 2 4s are 8, and then 2 2s are 4. So since 2 is there here, you cannot factorize it further. So it will be 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 is equal to 32. Okay, so this was prime factorization. In the next class, we'll study HCF and LCF. Alright, thank you students.